فؤادك الأيام فتى.
In manuscripts, مخطوطات. They said if you go to his house, rooms were manuscripts, only manuscripts. He used to work hard, put a lot of effort in making sure he compiled and he brought manuscripts, the makhtutat. He would look at them, whether it was makhtuta mubayyada, if it was muswadda, he would look into it. Shaykh Ahmad al-Ansari. And Shaykh Ahmad al-Ansari spoke about the writings of Ibn Taymiyyah and how much effort it needed. Reading and analyzing it and looking into it and how he wrote. He was fast in the way he wrote. His ibarat, his writing, his everything. He's a man you can summarize in one sentence by saying, Allah created Ibn Taymiyyah for this ummah. Allah created him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he stands up for this religion. That was the purpose. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala created Ibn Taymiyyah ala ma dhahara lana, that which is apparent to us. He didn't get married, he didn't have children. Ladhati dunya, that which the dunya's joy and everything. It was said that he didn't turn towards it, he turned away from it. So he only came, rahimahullah, for spreading his deen. The two jihads that a person, jihadu sayfi, and jihadu lisan. And with his pen. He fought with the Tatar, and he also fought with his, na'am. So Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Kathir rahimahullah said about him, Ibn Taymiyyah said, Ibn Kathir said about him, وَلَمَّا كَانَ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ سَابِعَ عَشَرَ شَوَّالِ عَمِلَ الشَّيْخ تَقِيُّ الدِّينَ Ibn Taymiyyah مِعَادًا فِي الْجِهَادِ وَحَرَّضَ فِيهِ وَبَالَغَ فِي أُجُورِ الْمُجَاهِدِينَ وَكَانَ مِعَادًا حَافِلًا جَلِيلًا. Ibn Taymiyyah stood up. This is his jihad and how he stood up to fight, rahimahullah ta'ala. He stood up and he brought the people together and he spoke to them, reminded them of the importance of jihad. The Tatar are coming. They're going to come into your lands. He talked about the ayat pertaining to jihad. He brought the ayat, all of them, that he needed, rahimahullah ta'ala, from the top of his head. And he done explanation on it. And he commented on it, rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'ah. He was a zahid, a person who turned away from this dunya. Ibn Rajab said about him, عُرِضَ عَلَيْهِ قَضَاءُ الْقُضَاةِ قَبْلَ التِّسْعِينَ وَمَشْيَخَةُ الشُّيُوخِ فَلَمْ يَقْبَلْ شَيْئًا مِنْ ذَلِكَ. He was given to be the judge. Are you with me? ولذلك the Qadi al-Qudat. Qadi al-Qudat right now, he's one of the, he's a ministry of defense. He's the ministry of justice. That's where the position he'd sit. His words are taken into consideration. He was given that type position to be a qadi, to judge. He said, "La." He was also given the mashiyakha to shuyukh, which is to be the head of all of these madaris that were there at Dimashqa. He said, "No." فَلَمْ يَقْبَلْ شَيْءٍ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. He refused. رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. He was a person who turned away from the dunya. As for his ibadah, the statement Ibn al-Qayyim said about him, that he said, "Inna fil dunya jannah." In this dunya, there is a jannah. مَنْ لَمْ يَدْخُلْهَا. Anyone who doesn't enter the jannah of this dunya, لَمْ يَدْخُلْ جَنَّةَ الْآخِرَةِ. لَمْ يَدْخُلْهَا مَنْ لَمْ يَدْخُلْ إِنَّ فِي الدُّنْيَا جَنَّةَ مَنْ لَمْ يَدْخُلْهَا لَا يَدْخُلْ جَنَّةَ الْآخِرَةِ. He won't enter it. وَقَالَ لِي مَرَّةً الْإِمَامُ ابْنُ الْقَيِّمِ said, so he said, in this dunya there's a jannah, God, paradise. Anyone who doesn't enter the paradise of this dunya, he will not enter the paradise of the hereafter. Iman. That's how he was. He's ibadah. He also one time said to me, saying this to who? He said this to Ibn al-Qayyim. He said to him, مَا يَصْنَعُ أَعْدَائِي بِي. What can my enemies possibly do to me? أَنَا جَنَّتِي وَبُسْتَانِي فِي صَدْرِي. My garden, my paradise is in my chest. إِن رُحْتُ فَهِيَ مَعِي لَا تُفَارِقُنِي. If I go, it goes with me wherever I go. I'm always happy. I have my jannah in my heart. إِنَّ حَبْسِي خَلْوَةٌ. My imprisonment is what? It's just me being alone to do my dhikr and my ibadat. وَقَتْلِي شَهَادَةٌ. Killing me is martyrdom for me. وَإِخْرَاجِي مِنْ بَلَدِي. Taking me out of my land is a siyahatun. It's a tourism. Everything. وَلِذَلِكَ. This is one thing you have to realize. You know who's going to gain happiness? Anyone. Learn this. This is a very powerful statement. Anyone who's going to gain happiness is the person who can turn hardship into good. Every hardship that comes, he is able to find a positive in it and focus on that positive part of it. That individual. Are you with me? Take a lemon. اصْنَعْ مِنَ الْلَيْمُونِ شَرَابًا حُلْوًا. Take lemon and make out of it a nice, tasty lemonade. Add sugar to it. Every situation, what do you do? Every situation. Is the lemon something nice? Does it taste nice? It's bitter, sour. But you add sugar to it to make every situation, you should be able to do that. To change it from its reality, or change it from how it is, and change it to what? Something that works in good for you. That's what Ibn Taymiyyah was, rahimahullah. And that only comes, brothers, of course, if you've tasted the sweetness of what? وَلِذَلِكَ Ibn Taymiyyah, when he was in prison, and they put him in prison, and they closed the doors on him, and the gates of the qal'a in Damascus, they closed the door on him. Ibn Taymiyyah looked back at the wall, and this is what he recited. فَضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِسُورٍ لَهُ بَابٌ بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ الرَّحْمَةِ وَظَاهِرُهُمْ مِنْ قِبَالِهِ الْعَذَابِ. Pay attention. This is exactly the point I was saying. When they closed the door on him and the gate is closed, he said, they have thrown and they have placed the wall. This is who? The munafiqeen and the mu'mineen. The munafiqeen, what are they going to be doing? They're going to try to be walking with the believers because the believers have light. So as they are walking with them, what does Allah tabarak wa ta'ala do? He places between them a wall. فَضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِسُورٍ. A big fortress, a big wall is placed between the believers and the munafiqeen. Now, this wall has two sides. The side which is on the other side where the munafiqeen are, what is it for them? وَظَاهِرُهُ مِنْ قِبَلِهِ الْعَذَابِ. They have been punished on the other side. Like in the inner side of it, what is it? Where the believers are in, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, بَابٌ بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. Mercy. Ibn Taymiyyah is trying to say that the prison I'm in, here is rahmah, and adab is over there. And then the munafiqeen will cry and to the believers, and what will they say to them? اقتبس. They will say to them, give us your light. اقتبسوا من نوركم. قيل ارجعوا وراءكم فالتبسوا نورا فضرب بينهم بسور. Go back and look for your own lights. And a fortress will be placed. There will be that darkness. And that shows you what? How he got the ayat and he used it fast and efficiently in the right places. And that's how he was. He was very patient. The scholars, they praised him. Imam al-Dhahabi said, Ibn Taymiyyah, al-Shaykh al-Imam al-Alim al-Mufassir al-Faqih al-Mujtahid al-Hafidh al-Muhaddith al-Shaykh al-Islam nadir al-Asr ذو التصاريف الباهرة والذكاء المفرطة. And he also said about him, كان قوالا بالحق. He was the one who uttered the truth. نهاء عن المنكر, he prohibited the evil. لا تأخذه في الله لومة لائم. It will not take him the blame of the blamer to stop him to say the haq, he will say it. Whoever wants to love him, love him for it. He was a person who went forward, courageous. وَعَدَمُ مُدَارَاتِ الْأَغْيَارِ وَمَنْ خَالَطَهُ عَرَفَهُ قَدْ يَنْسِبَنِي إِلَى التَّقْصِيرُ فِي وَصْفِهِ. Is there anyone who knows him? وَمَنْ خَالَطَهُ عَرَفَهُ. Anyone who mixed with Ibn Taymiyyah and knows Ibn Taymiyyah, قَدْ يَنْسِبُنِي, he might ascribe to me, ذَهَبِي, me, Ibn Taymiyyah, he might ascribe to me what? That I done what? إلى التقصير في وصفه, that I will came short in the description of Ibn Taymiyyah. He said about him also, لا يؤتى من سوء فهم بل له ذكاء مفرط ولا من قلة علم فإنه بحر زخار بصير بالكتاب والسنة عديم النذير في ذلك ولا هو بمتلاعب بالدين فلو كان كذلك لكان أسرع شيء إلى مداهنة خصومه وموافقتهم ومنافقتهم ولا هو ينفرد بمسائل تشهي فهذا الرجل لا أرجو على ما قلته فيه دنيا ولا مالا ولا جاها بوجه أصلا مع خبرة التامة به ولكن لا يسعني في ديني ولا في عقلي أن أكتم محاسنه وأدفن فضائله وأبرز ذنوبا له مغفورة في سعة كرم الله تعالى. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi praised him. Another place, Imam ibn al-Daqiq al-Id, rahimahullah, he said about him, مَا كُنْتُ أَظُنُّ أَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى بَقِيَ يَخْلُقُ مِثْلَكَ. Ibn al-Daqiq al-Id said, I never thought that Allah will ever create anyone like you again. I never thought that. Who said that? Ibn al-Daqiq al-Id. مَا كُنْتُ أَظُنُّ I never thought أَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى بَقِيَ يَخْلُقُ مِثْلَكَ that Allah will remain to create somebody like you. I never thought that would happen. He also said about him, when he met Ibn Taymiyyah, he said, لَمَّا اجْتَمَعْتُ بِإِبْنُ تَيْمِيَةَ وَلَا مَا إِبْنُ تَيْمِيَةَ رَأَيْتُ I saw him. رَجُّلُ الْعُلُومُ كُلُّهَا بَيْنَ عَيْنَيْهِ I saw that all knowledge was placed in front of him. In front of him. All of knowledge is just right there. Ibn Taymiyyah. يَأْخُذُ مِنْهَا مَا يُرِيدُ He takes whatever he wants. وَيَدَعُ مَا يُرِيدُ And he doesn't take whatever he wants. He's a choice. He knows what he wants. Everything is just there. Facilitated for him. رَحِمَهُ Abu al-Baqa al-Subki rahimahullah he said something very powerful about him. He said, Wallahi ya fulan, O person, ma yubghid ibn Taymiyyah. Wallahi, no one's going to hate ibn Taymiyyah illa jahil. Except the ignorant person. O sahibu hawa, or a person who has whims and desires in him. Faljahilu la yadri ma yaqulu. The ignorant one doesn't really know what he's saying. He doesn't know. وَصَاحِبُ الْهَوَى And the one who whims and desires runs in his veins, يَصُدُّ هَوَاهُ عَنِ الْحَقِّ بَعْدَ مَعْرِفَتِهِ بِهِ His whims and his desires will stop him from what? Huh? The haqq after he came to know it. If he comes to know it about Ibn Taymiyyah, he won't even acknowledge it because his whims and desires is not with it. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, his books are so much. ولذلك ابن رجب الحنبلي سير وأما تصانيفه فهي أشهر من أن تذكر وأعرف من أن تنكر صارت سير الشمس في الأقطار وامتلأت به البلاد والأمصار قد جاوزت حد الكثرة فلا يمكن أحد حصرها ولا يتسع هذا المكان لعد المعروف منها ولا ذكرها. His author, the books he wrote, he said it's too famous for me to mention them, and it's too known for me to reject them and ignore their existence. He said his books, they traveled where the sun travels. All over the world. وَامْتَلَتْ بِهَا الْبِلَادُ وَالْأَمْصَارِ It filled up the lands and the places and cities. Imagine this, wallahi. Ikhwani, this ayah, always remember this. فَأَمَّا الزَّبَدُ فَيَذْهَبُ جُفَاءً وَأَمَّا مَا يَنْفَعُ النَّاسَ فَيَمْكُثُ فِي الْأَرْضِ Things that are not beneficial, the bid'ah and the khurafat and the shirk, and that which is not done for the sake of Allah, it perishes, it goes, it won't stay, wallahi, it never will. But the thing that is done with ikhlas and sincerity, it will what? It will remain. Ibn Taymiyyah was in prison, his books were illegal. No one could take them. When the Tatar came, they threw many of his works into the ocean. What do you see today? Great scholars like who? AbdulRahman Yahya al-Muallimi, the Habib al-Asr, Sahib al-Tankil, al-Alusi, ulama'i Baghdad, Muhibbiddin al-Khatib, Muhammad Siddiq Hassan Khan, and other scholars, Ibn Qasim, rahimahullah, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, all of these scholars, when they came, they all worked on the books of Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn Qasim, he's the one who brought all the Majmu' al-Fatawa of Ibn Taymiyyah together. Rashid Rida, rahimahullah, Muhammad Rashid Rida, they all worked on the books of Ibn Taymiyyah. Muhammad Rida Salim, who brought out Dar'u Ta'aridhu Al-Aqli Wal-Naql, I think Safadiyya if I'm not wrong, but I'm sure Dar'u Ta'aridhu Al-Aqli Wal-Naql, Allahu Musta'an, Minhaj Al-Sunnah Al-Nabawiyyah, he brought it out. And this is what the time he was studying Cambridge University. He worked hard to get all the manuscripts, Muhammad Rashad Salim. He worked hard to making sure that he got Ibn Taymiyyah's works while he was in Cambridge University. He brought all the manuscripts together and he brought it out. Ibn al-Qasim and his son, the son and the father, both of them, what did they do? They both worked together to Ibn Taymiyyah's Majmu' al-Fatawa. They brought him together, compiled it together, organized it the way they did. And then all the books that are in there, Rasail, little books, they took it out and what did they do? Huh? They all made it into different. Wasatiyya is in the Majmu' al-Fatawa, became something mustaqil, it's taught, it's studied. Hamawiyya, brought out, studied. It's a question and answer, faqat. Tadmuriyya, Minhaj al-Sunnah al-Nabawiyyah, al-Safadiyya, Dar'u Ta'aridhu al-Aqli wal-Naql, قاعدة الجليلة في التوصل والوسيلة. Books of Ibn Taymiyyah, little, small, big, everything. Allah gave them individual Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, qabool, acceptance. So his mu'allafat, his works, al-istiqama, al-istighatha by Bakri, all of those, اقتضاء صراط المستقيم لمخالفة أصحاب الجحيم, Shaykh al-Islaam Taymiyyah, بيان تلبيس الجهمية, محمد رشاد سالم, he's the one who worked on that as well. الجواب الصحيح لمن بدل دين المسيح, Christians, rahimahullah ta'ala. All of those are what? He wrote a two-volume book called An-Nubuwat. Those who rejected the Prophet's prophecy and the mu'jizah and the karamat and matters pertaining to that. Minhaj al-Sunnah al-Nabawiyyah, he's refuted a man by the name of Alauddin al-Bukhari. Alauddin al-Bukhari, who was a khabith shi'i rafidhi. He refutes him. In that book, Minhaj al-Sunnah al-Nabawiyyah, it's a refutation on the rafidha and it's a refutation on who? Al-Qadariya. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, ma min ta'ifa, la firqa. There's not a sect or a group إلا قمع بدعتهم, except he destroyed their أصول الفاسدة, their false fundamental principles they stand on, كشفها, he clarified it to the people and brought it to their attention. الرافضة, الشيعة, the معتزلة, the جهمية, the مرجئة, all of the طوائف الضلال المبتدعون, Ibn Taymiyyah. That's why he is what? He is ناصر السنة قامع البدعة. He gave victory to the Sunnah and he destroyed innovation. Those who hate him are who? أهل الأهواء. Remember Abu al-Baqa al-Subki statement, إِمَّا جَاهِلْ وَإِمَّا صَاحِبُ هَوَى. He's either ignorant, and that person, you teach him and you educate him, it's أخي, you know, the reality of Ibn Taymiyyah, you don't know him, here he is. What do you have against the man? You know what's sad, wallahi al-azim? Wallahi is very sad. When shaitan blinds a people that much. What you see today is, in my country Somalia, there's a book, it's called Jawharatu al-Tawheed, Ibrahim al-Laqani, and Bayjuri, Jawharatu al-Tawheed. When you read that book, wallahi, there's a handful of ayat in the whole book. Everywhere else, i'lam, ha, an al-aqla, logic all day. قال الله, قال الرسول, is rare. Fakhruddin al-Razi, Sa'aduddin al-Taftazani, Bayjuri, Saifuddin al-Amidi. When you look at these individuals, and you look at their works, Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, when you look at these two, Abu Ma'ali al-Juwayni, you sit down and you look at these individuals, Abu Bakr al-Baqillani, Abu Bakr al-Mufawrak, you sit down and you look at these individuals Ibn Taymiyyah was always arguing with, you compare them to one book of Ibn Taymiyyah. Just take Aqidatul Wasitiyyah as an example. Aqidatul Wasitiyyah, how many times do you come across ayat? قال الله, قال الله, قال الله, قال الرسول, قال رسول الله, صلى الله عليه وسلم, قال الصحابة, قال التابعين, قال Go to one of the books of, written by any of these individuals and tell me you get ayat from the Quran. Rather, they clearly and explicitly state that the Quran in which we're reading and that we're studying and that we're giving so much importance to, huh, isn't the source which we should take our evidences from. The logic is what we should give precedence to. And that, that clear statements, man, not trying to understand that from their statements, clear cut. That if you want to understand the religion, don't use the Quran and the Sunnah. Don't. Then what should you use? Use your logic. Use your brain. Use your mind. Don't go to the Quran and the Sunnah. Rather, statements like, if you read the Quran will misguide you. The Quran will throw you into hawiya, destruction. And that logic should be given the precedence. That the logic should be what? The source of what? Our source of extraction. And not the Quran or the Sunnah. Statements like that. And it's sad that to that much, to that extent, huh? You still defend that person over a man who tells you that anybody, that the mazdar al-talaqi, where the source we take our religion from is what? Al-kitab al-sunnah wa ma'ajim alayhi salaf al-ummah. The kitab and the sunnah, and that which the pious predecessors unanimously agreed upon. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he died after he was put in prison and he read the Quran 80 or 81 times and he died in the ayah إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَنَهَرٍ فِي مَقْعَدِ صِدْقٍ عِنْدَ مَلِيكٍ مُقْتَدِرٍ. They took all his papers from him, they took everything from him, and he died reciting Surah Al-Qamar ayah 54 to ayah 55. Ibn Taymiyyah died reciting that. And the year he died, rahimullah, was 728. 728, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah died in Qal'atu Dimashqa whilst he was in prison. Rahimahullahu ta'ala. A lot of people came to his janazah. The people of tariq, the people who spoke about his life, such as Ibn Rajab, such as Imam al-Dhahabi, Al-Imam al-Kathir, they said, لَمْ يُسْمَعْ فِي جَنَازَةٍ بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْجَمْعِ إِلَّا جَنَازَةُ الْإِمَامِ أَحْمَدِ ابْنَ حَنْبَلِ. That after the janazah of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, there was no janazah as big as the janazah of Ibn Taymiyyah. The number of people who came, it was large in number. If you want to see the biography of Ibn Taymiyyah, that was only a very summarized version of the life of Ibn Taymiyyah. There are many books written about his life. The books you could go to is Al-Uqood al-Durriya min Manaqib Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah by Ibn Abdul Hadi. You can also go to Al-Shahadat al-Zakiyyah fi Thana'i al-A'immat ala Ibn Taymiyyah Limar'i Ibn Yusuf al-Karami al-Hanbali or Ibn Muflih Al-Maqsad al-Arshad fi Dhikri Ashab al-Imam Ahmad or Zaylu al-Tabaqat al-Hanabila Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali or Shudurat al-Dhahab fi Akhbari Man Dhahab Ibn Umad or الأعلام العلية في مناقب ابن تيمية باي الحافظ عمر ابن علي البزار أو الوابل الصيب من الكلم الطيب باي ابن القيم الجوزية أو الرد الوافر لابن ناصر الدين الدمشقي. Those are the books that speak about his life. The best one which written on his life was العقود الدرية من مناقب شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية by ابن عبد الهادي and دار عالم الفوائد. What they did was they published العقود الدرية. With it they bought the one written by الحافظ ابن علي البزار الأعلام العلية في مناقب ابن تيمية. They published them both together, so you can read both of them in one publication. So that's the life of ابن تيمية. We're going to start the book inshallah ta'ala.